Genesee County was a small, quiet community, secluded in the natural splendor of the countryside. No hassles and no problems. Until... It was a crime a small town never forgot. 7 years later, the speculation never stopped. A beleaguered sheriff, a jilted boyfriend, a hot-tempered local, a stranger in town, a grief-stricken brother, all of whom will be drawn together to find an answer to the biggest mystery of Genesee County. What is the secret behind the house on the hill? Next.
Thank you. on yesterday, but the door's swollen shut.
We'll just have to bust the window.
Oh, hell, John, it isn't worth the trouble. Okay, I officially attest that there are no signs of habitation, okay? I'm not going crawling through a window just for formality's sake. We both know no one's been here for 6 years. Barring sudden appearance of a long-lost relative, day after tomorrow, it's yours, all legal.
Well, you see that big yellow beast over there, Sheriff? Well, tomorrow I'm going to level this place. Bury all the old memories once and for all. Still won't have any sense that she's gone. I still expect to see her at the market or in the garden out back. She'd be preparing her roses for the winter right now. She had so much going for her.
Well, I'll never forget it so long as I live. It's a terrible way to die. Just terrible. I'd sure like to have solved that case.
There are those who think I did them both in for the inheritance.
Yeah. Well, there are those who think that a husband did it, took off. Well, at least the town folk think so. I, on the other hand, have my own theory. But never had any proof.
Place to hold so many memories, Sheriff. If only the walls could talk.
Well, there are those that still think she haunts the place, taking vengeance on any man that crosses the threshold. There's been disappearances.
Could you blame her? What she went through, even before her death? Married to that bastard with his jealous temper. She's entitled to some rage.
Come on, John. There's nothing more we can do here. The place is secured. Ah, let's go. I'll buy you some coffee.
Thank you. getting ready to go out. Robert? No, he doesn't know. It'll be a complete surprise. He'll be home in about an hour. Oh, I was looking forward to seeing you. I don't get to see you that much. I miss you. I love you. Come see me tomorrow. Okay. Goodbye.
Take me for a fool, Elizabeth. You think I don't know about the men you saved?
Oh, God!
Your loyalty. I've given you a home. I paid for the clothes on your back. It's Michael King, isn't it? You're seeing him, aren't you? He wouldn't marry you. Too imperfect. Too deformed to be his wife. Enough of a woman for his bed, though, right? Tell me, confess!
I'm sorry, Elizabeth. God forgive me. I didn't mean it. Elizabeth. Elizabeth. Tell me you'll forgive me. Tell me you'll love me.
Your jealousy frightens me. I love only you. Believe me.
bum 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 doo 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 oh doo 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 oh doo 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 doo
carburetor.
Hey.
Tough luck. Not too many people left in these parts. There's a big centennial celebration over there in Haleyville. Did you hear about it? Man, they're giving away new Mercedes Benz. Woohoo! I mean, we'll take a ride here. Let's see, no one's around, and you seem to be a babe in the woods. Maybe I could help you out some way.
Yes.
Much obliged, stranger. I'll call Eustace. It's not as regular beat, you understand, but he's my cousin. He owes me. Might as well make yourself comfortable, pal. It's gonna be a while.
Yeah, I expected a safe for Clacky to have one of them there, Mercedes.
Mercedes.
Yeah, Mercedes, whatever. Man, I always prefer my truck. You sure are a lucky fella. By the way, name's Eustace. Eddie Eustace. Just on my way to work when I got the call. It cost you about $100 to get to the next station. That okay?
Yeah, fine.
Yeah, just wasn't much of a life in towing. Kind of got bored after a while. I thought I had to try a new career track before it was too late. I never knew that embalming was so fascinating. Why, did you know?
Hey, wait. We're going in the wrong direction. I need to be 300 miles west of here before lunch tomorrow.
How far east are we going?
Nah, don't worry. Not too far, it's just a small town, about 20. And my brother-in-law's got the best service station in the area. He'll get you back on the road in no time, get you a good price, too.
No doubt. Don't you know any other place in the other direction? Save me some time, you know?
Sorry, I can't do that. My boss gets a little cranky. When my work starts to pile up, I'll tell you the truth, I'm late as it is right now. I can let you off here, but I can't give you any refunds.
Thank you.
Honey, here's you misplaced your boyfriend again.
No, he misplaced himself. Down a bottle, I expect. But, well, you know, it's getting cold, and I fear he'll catch his death without his jacket. Sheriff will find him. Always does.
Yeah, well, we'll get the sheriff tonight. It's poker night, you know. Yeah, you'll be lucky if you even get that deputy.
Thanks anyway.
Well, good luck anyhow. Yeah, deputy's not worth much anyhow. It usually takes him 48 hours to fill out a report. He's not much better than Barney Fife.
Excuse
why,
me.
Why? Why?
How long is this going to take?
Now it's going to be a while anyhow. Tootsie Roll?
Tootsie Roll? Is that what you've been chewing?
Well, what do you think I've been chewing? Snuff? It's a 90s pot. Stuff will give you lip cancer. Tell you what. It's going to be quite a while. Why don't you just go over to the bar over there? My wife's uncle owns it.
Your wife?
Yeah, what do you think you are, Mayberry? Well, my wife's uncle owns it. He'll get you in there. Just tell him Eustace sent you. He'll get you in there. Drinks are cheap. Food's not bad either. And I'll be over to get you as soon as your car is done, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Sure thing.
Right. That way, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. Just right across the street there. Okay. All right.
Thank you, sir.
Anywhere.
All turkey, double, no ice.
Don't let her get you. She had a bad experience with the yuppie once. Left her kind of grumpy.
And kind of pregnant.
Now, Everett, if you're going to be telling everybody's business, I'm going to call your wife and tell about your girlfriend. Eat your soup. I made it myself. Just what you need to keep you warm in a night like this.
I'd settle for a stiff drink and some peace and quiet.
Hey. That's my kid sister, buddy.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. It's just been a long, exasperating day. I apologize, miss. It's just that I have a very important meeting. And it may be long before my car is repaired.
Say it for the baby, but I see I'll make my own. And I'm here to pay a honey, and I'm bad for the phone.
is hell.
And not many people here.
No, there's some kind of centennial celebration over in Hadleyville.
So I heard.
Yes, but it's slow and that's the way I like it.
I blew right past! You should have seen this asshole. What a haircut.
Yo, Chief, can I have three beers and a bourbon chaser, please?
Anybody with a haircut like that, you know he's an asshole.
Damn straight. Hey, I'll tell you what, bring this out of the whole bottle. This is before it's getting married.
Congratulations, Mr. King.
You're breaking my heart, man. I can't believe it. You were my idol, the eternal bachelor. Love him, leave him. That's what I say.
Yeah, I used to say that too. My life's been empty for too long.
Tell you what, a woman have to be perfect to trap me. Beautiful face, nice body, good-natured, but fiery.
And no standards.
Son, you got it all wrong. You marry a woman, not some fantasy. And if you're lucky, you learn to live with the good and the bad.
That's so. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll take a vote. Ever? Never mind. Hey, mister, where you from?
Are you speaking to me?
Yeah, I'm speaking to you. Where are you from?
Connecticut.
You got a lot of pretty little ladies in Connecticut?
Please.
How about some pool? Let's go play some pool. How about you, Rosser? Go play some pool?
Yeah, sure. So, how do you know when you found the right one? Woman, I mean.
You don't always. You make mistakes. Screw up.
Yeah, take your chances.
Yeah, well, you can say that. So does she.
You love her, you don't, right?
Yeah. It'd be simple if only love were involved. But often it ain't. You know, I remember when I was about your age. I fell in love. Her name was Elizabeth. We got engaged.
You were engaged?
Yeah. I can remember it like it was yesterday. It was a beautiful night out. The stars and the moon were out. But anyway. Yeah, we went up to the river. You know where them kids built that tire swing. I took my shoes and socks off and went wading. She wouldn't go near the water. So I started teasing her. Started asking her stuff like, what's wrong, you got webbed feet? So I decided I was gonna put her in the water. So I went out onto the shore and grabbed her and started wrestling with her. I took her shoes off and she started screaming and kicking. And then I got her socks off, and she started bawling. And then I saw it. She was missing the middle toe of her right foot. Found out later it was some kind of a congenital defect.
Well, so what? I mean, big deal, right?
Yeah. That's what I said. I tried to comfort her. I finally convinced her that it just didn't matter.
Well, what happened? I mean, you didn't get married.
Yeah. I never admitted it to her. I told her that I just wasn't ready to settle down yet. And I broke off the engagement. She wasn't the same anymore. She was different. She
She wasn't perfect to me anymore. I started thinking to myself, hell, I'm a pretty good catch. I deserve better. I deserve something perfect. Started to wonder about, well, what else is she hiding from me? Started thinking about, what are the other guys gonna say when they find out that I married some deformed woman? I never admitted it to her. But she knew. It broke her heart. Eventually, I realized what an ass I'd been. But I'd lost. I'd lost something that... Something that comes from here. I don't know.
Well, I mean, in that case, why didn't you get back together?
And then it was too late. Some mistakes are permanent. She was dead. Murdered.
You're kidding. Did they catch who did it?
Nah. They never arrested anyone. But they sure as hell suspected a lot of people. Her husband, her brother, even me. If you ask me, I think her brother did it. I mean, hell, he can buy up anybody in this town. Then again, her husband left right after she died.
You're talking about that man murder, aren't you? Some guy was in here just the other day talking about it.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Man's been missing 7 years now. We declared legally dead tomorrow. Anyway, this guy was saying he thinks that the brother did it. Cut up his sister, and then the husband. Then he went and buried Manton in the woods out back. Anyway, this freaking brother is so weird. He's some kind of a consultant. He stays in his house all day and just works by computer. He never leaves. He always reads. I heard he doesn't even own a TV set. Very strange. Anyway, the house is worth a fortune alone. That is, if you can find someone who would want to buy a haunted house.
Haunted house? What's all this crap about a haunted house?
The old Manton place, about 5 miles up out of town. We was up for a party and drinking last year in the woods. Man, some pretty strange shit happened up there. We'll see you, buddy.
Yeah, somebody's in here the other day talking about that place. Elizabeth Manton roams the house. Waiting for a killer to return. Where's her husband? I can't remember.
Hey, I get off in a half an hour. Can I leave early?
Yeah, good. Business is kind of slow,
buddy. Thanks, you're a real dog.
Heard tell you got to the house after dark. You'd sometimes see her staring from an upstairs window. Her bedroom window, I think.
Yeah, bet you a lot of your customers have already seen her. Tell you what. Where are these suckers? Probably see over there playing pool with the boys. Where'd you say this place was, Mike?
What are you so interested for? You believe in ghosts or something?
I like to keep an open mind.
More like an open sewer.
Come on, baby. You know I got what you want. But I ain't that drunk yet.
In your dreams.
Hey, cool it.
Me! Bitch! Man, why do you keep her? She finds the customers.
You know where his daddy is?
Spoken at. This might be disturbed.
He's got an election coming up. If this one starts tearing up the town again, he ain't gonna get elected cowpat account, much less sheriff. And that was just waiting for Sanders to screw up his daddy's re-election bid.
And everything. Maybe we'll get lucky. Maybe she's one of them, what you would call it, those things.
Succubus.
Yeah, that's right, right, a succubus.
A poltergeist.
Right, a poltergeist, right. Hey, say, you ain't superstitious, is you?
Oh, not in the least.
Good, then you're invited.
Dead's dead. Except if you're half-witted, there are three sheets to the wind. Nor do I see much promise in sex after death.
I tell you what, I like this guy. Bartender, get this guy whatever he wants to drink on me. Oh, by the way, this is Bill Rosser, Matt King, and I'm John Sand.
No, thank you. I need to get my work done. May I see a menu, please?
Pardon me. I guess you think I'm just some kind of a dumb country hick or something. This country boy could whoop your ass without even getting wind.
Please, your friend is drunk. Can he hold his liquor?
Yeah, I'll show you that.
Yeah, you dumb hick.
Hey. It's usually a pretty friendly sound, you know. Mr.
Thomas. James Thomas.
So, Mr. Thomas, where are you from anyway?
Connecticut. I used to be an insurance salesman, but I was promoted to regional manager, and I've been traveling most of the time, and I'm waiting for my car to be repaired. I should be off soon.
Good. Hey, why don't you get your buddy cleaned up back here? Pour some Ipecac down his throat. Should take some of the glory out of him. Make him more manageable for you. Be in a great mood now. Hey, Rosser, want to give me a hand?
Did you come and tell me my car's ready?
Nah, well, got some bad news. Probably not gonna get it done in the morning. But my sister does run out some rooms over in the hotel. She can get you a special rate.
Oh, that'll be the city slicker rate, huh?
Oh, nah, don't get all bent out of shape. Next time buy American, you won't have this trouble.
Hey, hey! I wouldn't walk down any dark alleys if I was you.
sober as a judge now. If you so much as lay one hand on me, it'd be the last thing you'd do.
Eustace, how much would it cost to get my car done by midnight?
What are you talking about?
Like 100, 200?
What do you mean?
I think I entered into an episode of The Twilight Zone.
Hey, what you got there is my fine. How about a little on account?
Sure, there you go.
Pleasure doing biz with you, sir. Howdy. Oh, don't worry, it's just me, the dumb hick. Think all that money makes you balls? Pressing all the country folk with all those greenbacks, huh? Ooh, yes, sir. Anything you say, sir. Is that what you think? Huh?
Listen, I just want to get home.
Well, I sure could use a few extra bucks. Got any extra spare change to impress me with? Also take American Express.
You give that back right now. Bartender, you're a witness to this. Tell him to give it back or I'll turn his butt into the police.
Yeah, but money's money. And I don't see your name on it. I see him with it now.
It's over $600.
Hey, I ain't gonna be a part of this. I'm a respectable citizen. I got too much to lose. Why don't you just let it go, Sancher?
I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll make it a clean, fair fight. And the money we can be yours legal.
Yeah, what would you have in mind?
Ah, bare knuckle fight.
Clear the bar.
Fair boxer. Talent? You can't keep up with me, can you, huh? Here I go.
Oh, get me from behind. Come on.
Come on, boy. Chill out, boy. I'll kick your butt. Come on. Woo, yeah. Look at me. Oh, what are you looking at? Come on.
Come on, Chump.
Yeah. Come on, Chump. What are you standing there for? You getting tired yet watching me? Ha. Come on. Look at it. Come on. Now I'm moving. I'm moving now. Ooh. Come on. Mm-hmm. Ooh, almost got your nose there, huh? Come on.
You win, you keep the money. I win, you buy me a drink.
A drink? Is that all? Are you trying to tell me you can afford to lose this much money?
I'm not gonna lose.
Well, is that what you think? Well, if you wanna fight, then let's fight.
Not in my bar, boys.
Then you pick the place.
All right.
But as long as he's with us.
What for?
Well, you said a minute ago that you were an honest citizen, and you have everything to lose, and make it seem like a fair fight. And I want my money back.
Hey, I'm up for a fight, so long as it's fair. And I ain't in it. Besides, if it's fair, no one can go to jail, right?
Agreed. You pick the place.
Steve, we have any candles?
I have the perfect place.
Still love an accommodating woman.
Oh, but then again, you know more about that stuff than I do. Bet you two got a lot of catching up to do, eh? Kind of weird how that door's open.
You know, I hope you're drunk.
Why?
You know, I'm getting sick of your smart-ass comments.
What's up?
Well, if you want to step in for me, I'll pass.
Nothing doing. Forget about it. I want myself some money.
Hey, look. It's not like I believe in ghosts or anything, man. But this place gives me the creeps. I wonder if there's still blood stains. Where'd they find
them? Upstairs. In the bedroom.
I think the downstairs will be fine. What's the matter with you?
This is all that's left of Elizabeth. Silence. I miss the sound of her laughter, even now.
Hey there, we ready to start?
Yeah, we're ready. Now remember, this thing ain't over unless one of us is unconscious. Or cries, Uncle.
Do the honors.
He's good.
Gentlemen,
you may withdraw.
No way, Sancho.
Get the hell out! Unless, of course, my opponent has some objection.
None.
Well then, I'm ready when you are. What do you mean?
Well, you wanted me here. What's your plan?
Teach you a lesson. That's all.
Dusty.
You know, I never thought I'd see the old place again.
I've gone through some pains to avoid it. But lately, I've been having some rotten luck.
What the hell are you talking about?
I did see the recognition in King's eyes. He couldn't cover it. This is usually a friendly town. Bingo. I do know you. Oh, I'm sorry. We haven't been properly introduced. I'm Robert Manton. And I used to live here. I find it quite interesting. I've read the local newspaper for the past 7 years and the speculation of her death. And I find it quite amusing. Some people say I'm a serial killer. Other people say that the killer buried me in my own backyard. You don't know what to think at all, do you? You brought this upon yourself. I just wanted to be on the road. And you had to interfere. You had to push me to the brink, just like she did. Her death was inconsequential. But yours is necessary, I'm afraid. I'll take care of you first. Then I'll do your friends next. I'll be miles away before they know what's even happened. You dumb hicks are so ridiculous. You'll think that a ghost did it.
Sure as hell ain't gonna make it easy on you.
My father was a butcher. Taught me how to use a knife. I could skin a deer. Every time I shoot aces, one cut. That's all it takes.
I play you live, country boy.
Not if you can't find me. I don't like this, Mike.
Oh, don't worry about it. Sancher can take care of himself.
But what, man? That's not the point. What are we doing here?
Don't you remember that time down at the bar?
Oh, that
don't
big
you remember?
Deal, man. Big deal.
Them two college
like
kids jumped
man.
Him.
I don't all like
this. All right, he can take
all.
Care of himself.
I don't like being here. I don't like this place.
All right.
Give me the creeps,
all right, look.
Man.
Look, he ain't got a gun in there. They're both unarmed.
Oh, good.
What are they going to do? Where's he gonna go? He's locked in the house, all right? All we gotta do is wait for the sheriff here, okay?
Don't go to the freaking highway. What are we talking about this for? We can go get him.
Oh, wait. What's that gonna prove?
Gonna prove? Well, you took an awful chance leaving him in there with him.
I didn't know it was him, okay?
Oh, Christ. You set us up, man.
No, I didn't know it was him.
You know it was him, you son of Jesus.
Jesus!
Keep your goddamn wits about you! Goddamn! I was the one that was trying to get killed in there! Let's figure out what we're gonna do.
Alright, here's what we're gonna do.
What?
Sancher, here. You take my car, okay, and you go get the sheriff. Rosser and I are gonna stay here and make sure he doesn't go anywhere.
I swear, man, be careful, man. You're dealing with murder in there.
Mind to suffer, listening.
You dumb hick. You should have left me alone when you still had the chance.
I'll find you, Sancho. Sooner or later.
There's no law in the God-given world that says the Myers dog can't bark at 1 a.m. Cows? No, I don't own a cow. Janet, I'm not coming out there. I just lost my butt in the poker game. Why do you think it can't get any worse?
Sheriff! 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 I got something, man!
Sheriff, Looney Tunes back.
Janet, I gotta go. Aliens just landed on my front lawn, and I gotta go save the planet. Yes. Goodbye.
Sheriff, you are not gonna believe the story. Wait till you hear this.
Sancher, before you begin, don't. I don't want to deal with it. Whatever you got to say, you know, it can wait till after I finish my coffee. What are you doing up so late, anyway?
Sheriff, we have them trapped in the house. We got a killer trapped.
Oh, a killer. Well, that's different.
Yeah, we got him trapped. We got him trapped in the house. He can't escape. Come on.
Oh, like the time you called me about all those Iraqi terrorists that were looting all the 7-Elevens in town. Or, even better, remember the time you tried to convince me about all those little creatures that multiply when you throw water on them?
Sheriff, listen to me. This is different now. This is much different. I'm as sober as a priest on Sunday. Now listen. We got him trapped inside the house, the killer. Up there on that, what the hell's that road? Lake Pine, Lakewood? Lake Pine, oh, Jesus. Lakeview Drive, that's it. He's up there on Lakeview Drive. Now come on, let's go.
Lakeview Drive?
Yeah.
Which house?
The old man house.
Come out sooner or later. I promise it'll be a quick and painless death. Ooh, onto a dumb country boy.
Where the hell are you?
here! Deputy! On my mark!
I'm going in too. It's after midnight. It's my house now.
Okay! You boys, stay out here! Okay! Stand there! Let's give him a little surprise! Okay, Murph! Hit it!
Check it out. Trophy around his damn neck the past 7 years.
Elizabeth. Gave that to her for her birthday.
Well, I'm gonna go call the coroner.
Heart attack?
Oh, wasn't his freaking conscience, man.
Jesus.
guys thought I was the one to kill Calista. And I did not know him.
After all these years.
Look, is that really scared? Bullshit!
I'll say.
Me both, man.
Ha ha ha!